For our Spartans, we're getting live action from the Astro Park, St. San Isidro Sports Complex in the western suburbs of Mumbai. It's the Sports 360 Degree versus the Bevora Spartans. It's the all-important match. It's Sports 360 who desperately need a victory. They are at the bottom part of the table. And so are the Bevora Spartans. Strong team that they are. It's going to be 360. Sports 360 will be batting first. And they'll need to get a good score on the target. What we've generally seen is 150 runs. That guarantees you a victory. Very rare chances of 150 run being scored so far in the Dreams Premier League as of today. 150 run has definitely been a winning score after you have batted first. In the meanwhile, it's going to be Sports 360 batting first. It's 8:15 in the evening. Nice, pleasant atmosphere here. They start with a single, Sports 360 Degree. On the offside, the extra covers fielder. And they get a single to start the proceedings for Sports 360 Degree. Outside the off stump, and he's beaten. So it's the second delivery that has been bowled by Sumit Jagwani. And it's one for no loss. It's Kadam who's the man on strike. Siddesh Kadam going for the switch hit and gets the Rialta Spaces sixer. Nicely played there. Definitely had decided, the premeditated shot it was, decided, and it's a big crowd support that has come in for the Sports 360 Degree. You can see a lot of yellow shirts in the spectators area, and that's the first Rialta Spaces sixer of this match coming from the bat of Siddesh Kadam. Jagwani countering, Siddesh Kadam on the leg side, straight to the field at deep mid wicket, and that's a Spartan poker catch of the match. Big wicket indeed. It's Siddesh Kadam who's got a nice sixer with a switch hit. Goes with a traditional shot over deep mid-wicket. Wasn't able to clear him. And straight to the fielder. And that's a Spartan poker catch of the match. Taken by Abhishek Dhoke. And that's a wicket for Sumit. There we have a look in the replay again. Straight to the fielder. He just had to take a step ahead. And nicely pouched. 7 for 1. 4 deliveries bowled. Sports 360. In comes Hanoi Kumar of the game changers category. He literally have to change the game for the Sports 360. It's Jagwani. He's picked up a wicket in the 4 deliveries that he's bowled. Outside the off stump, Hanoi Kumar. Nice struck over drive there. Nicely fielded. Good footwork. Super running between the wickets. They've converted the single into 2. Is Hanoi Kumar and Karan Sonawale. Gets 2 runs. 9 runs on the board. We're getting live action from Astro Park, St. San Isidro Sports Complex. From Bandra West in Mumbai. And for the first time, underarm turf cricket is live on a sports channel, and we're getting live action on D-Sport. Going for the helicopter shot was Hanoi Kumar, not able to connect. Buys is the single that we get from the umpire, and that's going to be a single to end the first over. At the end of the first over, Sports 360 are 10 for 1. It's been a good start for the Bevora Spartans. They have picked up a wicket, and it's always the openers, at least the first 3 batsmen for any team batting first, who have to lay a strong foundation for the middle order and the tail enders to come in the last half of the innings and get those 4s and 6s. In the meanwhile, it's going to be Hanoi Kumar, the game changer, back on strike. It's going to be Saif Ali, the bowler. Jersey number 00 there. Outside the off stump and good delivery. No, it's a wide ball that has been signaled. We'll be disappointed, is Faisal. Just gifting away a run. It's important not to give away those wides and no balls in this form of cricket. Wide is still fine, but a no ball will be penalized by a free hit. With an open stance is Hanoi Kumar. He'll be looking to go over the leg side boundary. There he goes on the offside this time. A straight drive, but it's been cut off by the fielder at long on. Just a single for Hanoi. Gets Karan back on strike. Is the Rialta Spaces presents Dreams Premier League, co-sponsor Radio City 91.1 FM and powered by Zord. Yorker length again, nicely played straight to the fielder at mid-on. Going for the overthrow, it is deflected from the board behind the wicketkeeper. That will be a dot ball, very rare in underarm cricket, but that is what has happened. 1.2 overs, 12 for 1. Yorker length, this has been a brilliant bowling by Faisal Khan. Giving absolute no room for either Karan or Hanoi to clear their arms. Just getting those singles. Gets Hanoi Kumar now on strike. 13 for the loss of a wicket. Straight to the field at mid-on. Chance for a run out. It had Karan. It was Karan who had slipped. a big appeal, but the umpire turns it down without even referring it to the third umpire. So it was clear that Karan Sonawale had made his ground. We'll have a look at that again. Good delivery straight to the fielder at mid-on. It was the call of the striker, but the non-striker just ball watching ran. And yes, good decision, brilliant decision by the umpire. It was Sonawale back who made it back in this ground. In the air, fielder under it, not able to get hold on to it. It was a good attempt, always difficult running backwards. Saif Ali, the fielder there, very difficult running backwards. But a good partnership between Sufyan and Saif that saves two runs for the team. Just two runs taken, 15 for the loss of a wicket, 1.5 overs. It's still Faisal who continues round the wicket to Hinoy Kumar on the leg side. Firmly struck, it was an offside. Firmly struck and off drive. And that's a Real Task Basis 4 that comes to the end of the second over. Sports 360 are 19 for the loss of a wicket. We'll have a look at that again. The open stance, so it looks like he'll be playing it to the leg side. But it bisected the long on and long off for a Real Task Basis 4. At the end of two overs, Sports 360 are 19 for 1. So not a lot of runs that they have scored. They're just going at 9.5 runs per over. But they have ensured that they haven't lost a lot of wickets. Just a wicket lost. So that's good news for Sports 360. They need to get a victory under the belt. Saif Ali, the new bowler. He'll again be bowling around the wicket. It's Karan Sonawale taking perhaps an off-stump guard that he's taken. He's covering all the stumps. It's a no ball signaled by the umpire at mid-wicket. That means the ball did not fall beyond the halfway line. So that's going to be a free hit. Can they capitalize? No, not able to capitalize. Karan Sonawale on the leg side. Just a single. He'll be disappointed. He had all the license to go for the big heave, but wasn't able to connect. Gets Hinoy Kumar. Just have a look at that strike there. The stance that he's taken. Complete open stance. On the leg side. Fielder there. No. Straight over the bowler's head. Real Task Pacer sixer. So Hinoy Kumar is turning it on. Super shot. Straight over the bowler's head. Six number 1069 in the Real Task Pacer's presence. Dreams Premier League. Yes, it's Hinoy Kumar who's on strike, batting on 15 of 7 deliveries. Yorker length on the offside, and that'll be another boundary. Real Task Pacers 4. So Hinoy Kumar has decided now, enough of singles and twos. I'll be going for the fours and sixers. Remember, they were put into bat. The Beora Spartans won the toss. They put the 360 degree, Sports 360. Apologies, into bat. And they are 31 for 1. Just 2.3 overs that have been bowled. Hinoy Kumar turning it on. Batting on 19 of just 8 deliveries. Saif Ali has bowled 3 deliveries and has conceded 12 runs. Just making a couple of changes in the field for Hinoy Kumar with again that weird open stance that he's batting with. Low full toss, not connected, field under it. And this time they have held on to it. Spartan poker, catch of the match. And the dangerous looking Hinoy Kumar will have to walk back. 31 for the loss of 2 wickets. We'll have a look at that again. It was in the slot to be hit, but Hinoy just wasn't able to connect it well in the air. The fielder at mid-on running behind, holding on to it, making absolute no errors. And that's a Spartan poker catch of the match. In comes Arvind Tanle. So a game changer being replaced by a game changer. Hinoy Kumar dismissed, and in comes Arvind Tanle. 31 for the loss of 2 wickets as Sports 360 in 2.4 overs. They crossed ends, so it's going to be Karan Sonawale on strike. Has scored 3 runs only in 5 deliveries that he's faced. On the leg side, and that's a Real Task Pacers 4. There was a deep square leg, but he hit it over the mid-wicket fielder. And one bounce into the fence. Real Task Pacers 4. 35 for the loss of 2 wickets. Saif Ali still continuing around the wicket. In the slot. Is it over the fielder? No, it is not. Straight to the fielder at deep mid-wicket. And Karan Sonawale will also have to walk back. This is trouble for the Sports 360. They were going good, but all of a sudden, two back-to-back wickets. And it's trouble for Sports 360. Nicely taken there in the air. Good work by the camera team. And it's Karan Sonawale who will have to walk back 7 runs that he scored off 8 deliveries at the end of 3 overs. Sports 360, a 35-3. Not a good way to enter the Nitton Valve Presents Double Trouble Over. We keep mentioning that is the most important over in the innings and is the third over's momentum that you have to carry in the fourth over, but not happening on this occasion for Sports 360. There we go. Is the Nitton Valve Presents Double Trouble Over. New man coming in is Amol Mhatre of the Heroes category. He'll be taking strike. Amol Mhatre will be on strike, and at the end of 3 overs, Sports 360, a 35-3, it's the Nitton Valve Presents Double Trouble Over. The reason we call it as the Double Trouble Over, the reason we call it as a double trouble over, number of runs scored gets doubled, wicket lost is minus 10. On strike is Amol Mhatre. He's also one of the team owners of Sports 360 Degree. 3 overs, 35-3, and all important double trouble over. Rohan Naik takes responsibility. Down the leg side, white ball. 2 runs to be counted for. So he cannot afford to give those extras. In the meanwhile, we'll head over to Preeti in the dugout.
Here we are at the dugout once again, and we have Vishnu Adhikari, the owner of Sports 360 Degree, with us. So, kaise chal rahi hai match ab tak?
Going good, average, thik thak hai. Not so good, not so bad, but we have a batsman left, so we are looking somewhere around score around 130-140. Okay. We reach.
So, tell me about the double trouble over which is going on right now. So, what is your expectation in this over?
We are expecting the score should go in somewhere around 70. Uh-huh. Hoping to, somewhere around 35 to 40 runs in double trouble over.
So, you are hoping to get 35 to 40 runs just in this one over? You think it is possible?
I think anything possible. We know about cricket. It's the last ball. We can't see anything in cricket.
Okay. And what are your views about your opponents? Do you think they are a very strong team?
We can't say that. You know, kai baar game achha ho jata hai. So you can't say anything, you know. So till now they are good. The bowling is very good.
So till now, I mean, this match has been so far good. But isse pehle jo aapne matches kheli hai, how have they been for you?
It was a good experience. We have learned a lot from our past 3 matches. So we have come up with a new strategy for this 4th match.
Okay. So lots of new strategies, lots of learnings, and let's take a look at what happens next at the turf. Thank you so much.
Yes, a lot of action in the meanwhile in the double trouble over. We had a drop catch. A 6 scored. Arvind Tanli was dropped. Arvind Tanli scored a sixer and a 4 in the double trouble over. 14 runs that came out of it. So 28 to be counted for in the Nitton Valve Presents double trouble over. 4 runs of the last delivery. So 28 runs scored in the Nitton Valve Presents double trouble over for Sports 360. We'll have a look at that again. Arvind Tanli, the game changer on strike, opening the face of the bat over the extra covers fielder. 1 bounce into the boundaries line. Rialta spaces 4 to end the 4th over. Sports 360, a 63 for the loss of 3 wickets. Rohan Naik considering 14 runs to be counted for as 28 in the Nitton Valve Presents double trouble over. Yes, there was also Arvind Tanli who was dropped. So that could prove expensive. Had the catch been taken, it would have been minus 10. But however, it's just ifs and buts. And 4 overs, 63-3, our Sports 360. The new bowler is going to be Chauhan, Sufyan Chauhan, to be the next bowler. On strike is one of the co-owners of Sports 360, Amol Mhatre. 4 overs, 63-3. They'll have to increase their strike rate and their 63-3. They need to get at least 130-140 on the board if they need to pose a threat. In the meanwhile, it's a full toss straight to the fielder at extra covers, and he is held on to it. That's a Spartan poker catch of the match, and the co-owner of Sport 360, Amol Mhatre, will have to walk back. It's a big wicket, wicket number 4 for the Bevora Spartans. We'll have a look at it again. Flighted delivery, full toss, below the waist for sure. And it's a good catch taken. Won't say difficult, but it had to be taken eventually, and it was Danish who was the fielder who held on to it. Nicely taken by Danish Deshmukh, 63 for the loss of 4 wickets. And they crossed ends, so it's going to be Arvind Tandle on strike, batting on 11 of 4 deliveries. Yorker length, nicely driven, it's the power play over, and gets 4 runs. Realta spaces 4 from the game changers bat, Arvind Tandle. He's just got 4 runs. Arvind Tandle moves on to 15 of 5 deliveries. It's 67 for the loss of 4 wickets, 4.2 overs. Bewra Spartans won the toss and put the Sports 360 into bat. It's Sufyan Chauhan the bowler. Arvind Tandle comes down the track and makes most of the power play over. And that's another Realta spaces 6. Arvind Tandle is making the most of the power play over. A maximum of 4 fielders are allowed on the boundary line. That gives a lot of scope to score. 71 for 4, we head over to Preeti.
So here I have with me Mr. Esam Bakshi, owner of Bewra Spartans. So how is it going? How's the match so far?
So far it's going great for us, as expected. And we won the toss, chose to field. This kind of score we were looking out for in the fourth and fifth over. So it's going on to us so far.
So do you think a fielding first was the right decision to make?
Yeah, well, see, it depends upon team to team. Who's the opponent and what kind of strength they have. Looking on to today's game, yes, very much, it was a very crucial toss for us. We wanted to win it, you know, let the opposition go inside, set a target for us and know what we are playing for, how much.
So what score could you think of restricting them at?
The lowest, the better. I don't want to encourage them at this stage, but even, I guess, I would like to restrict them anything under 120, 130. I think
they are at 77 already, right, and 4.4 over. So do you think it's easy to restrict them?
Yeah, it's like 3 overs to go from now, and maybe we have 1 or 2 key bowlers also left. So hope so, they'll do a good job.
So let's hope for the best, and over to the turf.
Yes, in the meanwhile, it was Arvind Tandle in full form, batting on 27 of 7. He's getting those 4s and 6s at ease. And Sufyan Chauhan has already considered 20 runs in the 5 deliveries that he's bowled. Going for the switch hit, connects well, Realta spaces 6er. So 26 runs coming off that over number 5 of Sufyan Chauhan. Arvind Tandle, the game changer, definitely turning it on for the Sports 360. It's 89 on the board for Sports 360 degree at the end of 5 overs. 89 for 4. And that was 6 number 1073 of the Realta Spaces Presents Dreams Premier League. They are going at 17.8 runs per over. Yes, we can see the crowd is gathered here at the Astro Park at St. Stanislaus Sports Complex in Bandra West, Mumbai. It's 89 for the loss of 4 wickets, 5 overs. There has to be a bowling change because a bowler can bowl a maximum of an over. It's going to be Abhijit Doke, again of the game changers category for the Bewra Spartans, bowling the 6th over. It's going to be Roshan Dhingra on strike. He scored 4 runs of the only delivery that he's faced. So if he can continue that performance, Sports 360 will be mighty pleased. Or all he can do is just get a single and get the power hitter Arvind Tandle back on strike. If they keep continuing scoring at 17.8, they can reach 140. But after this over, they'll be aiming to get 150. So that is 60 runs of the remaining 3 overs. Outside the off stump, is it a wide waiting for the signal from the umpire? No. So that was off the bat. No signal coming in. So it was definitely a thick outside edge of Roshan Dhingra. And that's get a single. There we go. We have the crowd gathered at the Astro Park. It's nice, exciting underarm turf cricket, gully cricket. And as the hashtag goes, Ab India Dekhega Gully Cricket. In the meanwhile, going on the leg side, top edge, but falling in no man's land. On the offside, all fielders on the boundary line. So there was no chance for a fielder getting hold on to it. That'll be a single for Arvind Tandle. Gets Roshan Dhingra back on strike. Just look at that backlift. He is looking to clear the fence. Good delivery. Super bowling, that is, from Abhishek, giving absolute no scope for Roshan Dhingra to clear his arms, and that'll just be a single. Gets Arvind Tandle back on strike. 92 for the loss of 4 wickets at Sports 360. Outside the off stump again. That is super stuff by the bowler, giving absolute no room. That is the place to bowl in any form of cricket. Yorker outside the off stump, difficult for the bestest of best batsmen to score off it. And the underarm cricket as well, it is considering, it is proving to be a game changer. Low full toss on the leg side, and a real task spaces for Roshan Dhingra. Much needed it was in this over. Just a single that we had seen in this over. We'll have a look at the replay. It's 97 for 4 in the meanwhile. There we go, it was a low full toss on the leg side, making the most of it. And a real task spaces for last delivery of the sixth over coming up. 97 for the loss of 4 wickets, a sports 360 degree. Again, a low full toss. It's a no ball signaled by the umpire behind the wicketkeeper. That means it was a side arm action by Abhishek. It was a good over so far, bowled by Abhishek. But that is an error that he's committed. It was Abhishek Dhoke who's the bowler, which will result in he being penalized by a free hit. And to make matters worse for him, it is going to be Arvind Tandle, the man on strike, who's striking it nice and long. Low full toss, he struck it well, but straight to the fielder, nicely taken. However, it was a free hit, so just a run to be counted for. Will they go for the... No run taken on the overthrow. Just a single to end the sixth over. At the end of six overs, sports 360 are 1-0-0 for 400 on the board. At the end of sixth over for the sports 360, they have kept 6 wickets in hand. Arvind Tandle, Roshan Dhingra. Arvind Tandle is batting on 40 of just 12 deliveries. Roshan has got a nice 4 that he scored on the first delivery. He wasn't able to make the most of the remaining 3 deliveries that he's faced. All these only taken 3 singles. But they'll be looking to make the most of the remaining 12 deliveries. In comes the skipper of Sports 360, Manan Mehta, to bowl over number 7. It's 100 for 4, our Sports 360 degree. It's 8:30 in the evening. It's a nice, pleasant atmosphere here at the St. Stanislaus Sports Complex. Full toss, again, premeditated from Arvind Tandle. Thus, all he'll get is one run. Had he not gone for the premeditated shot, he could have easily converted that into a Rialta Spaces sixer, but wasn't to happen. Swept it straight to the fielder at deep mid-wicket, and there'll just be a single. Manan Mehta will be mighty pleased with that. The first delivery that he's bowled has just got him a single. 101 for the loss of 4 wickets. Roshan Dhingra on strike. Again, an open stance indicating that he'll be looking to clear the leg side boundary. Yorker, good chance, good attempt by Manan Mehta. 100% commitment. So good to see that. We'll have a look at that in the replay again. It was hit straight back at him. It was in a matter of seconds, not even a second, that the ball travelled on the second chance. But it was way too difficult. But he's definitely scored 4, saved 4 runs for his team, is Manan Mehta. Full toss on the offside in no man's land. Falls right in between the 3 fielders. That'll just be a single for Roshan Dhingra. Roshan perhaps unhappy with the performance of his bat. So just getting changes of the bat. And that's something we've seen in DPL, that the bat, if you've seen carefully, the other side of the bat has been chiseled in a way that it doesn't become heavy, that you can see over there. The back side of the bat has been chiseled so that the chunk has been removed. So it doesn't get heavy, but still the required amount of meat has been kept on it. Arvind Tandle on strike over the long on fielder. Rialta spaces sixer for Arvind Tandle. He moves on to 47 of just 14 deliveries. 108 on the board for Sports 360 degree. So what was looking as a 140 score is still achievable. If Arvind Tandle keeps striking like that, Manan Mehta still continues over the wicket. On the offside, the ball is definitely going to turn. Good work by the fielder Faisal there. He was there stationed. He realized that the ball is going to turn. And making no mistakes, just a single for Arvind Tandle. 109 for 4, 6.5 overs. Last delivery of the 7th over. Manan Mehta has done good work. If you've conceded 9 runs in 5 deliveries, that's a super effort. But he'll have to finish it well. That always is what matters. If you have bowled 5 good deliveries, you have to finish it well. And he does. Straight to the fielder at the widest long on. And that'll just be 2 runs. Manan is unhappy with the performance of the fielder. But it was good running between the wickets by Roshan and Arvind. 2 runs to end the 7th over at the end of 7 overs. It's single Nelson for Sports 360 degree. 1-1-1 for four. There we see the supporters of Sports 360 with the tattoos, temporary of course, and also these just face drawings with the logo of Sports 360 degrees. Sports 360 are 111 for four in seven overs. Big crowd support for Sports 360. They are in big numbers wearing those yellow jerseys of Sports 360. You've seen those face paintings as well. There we go, the face sticker it is that we can make out of Sports 360. Always good to see that commitment from the crowd and from the supporters. Yes, you're on TV there. Seven overs, 1-1-1 for four. In comes Mukadam to bowl the penultimate over of the innings. It's Adnan Mukadam to bowl to Arvind Tandle. 111 for four in seven overs. Arvind Tandle will be looking to clear the fence on every delivery. Comes down the track, not able to make connection at his full stretch. That will be a single, however. Will that be wise? It's wide. So no trouble for Sports 360 degree. They haven't wasted a delivery. They get two runs, two wides to be counted for. So it's 113, gets a Roshan on strike. We'll have a look at that in the replay again. Yes, turned. A lot of spin on that. And on the overthrow, they get a run. Arvind Tandle scampers for the single. Gets Roshan Dhingra on strike. 113 for four and seven overs. Our Sports 360 degree. Adnan Mukadam is considered two runs and not even a delivery that is bowled. He's bowling around the wicket to Roshan Dhingra. Now off the back foot, over the square leg fielder. Rialta space is four. Rialta space is six, pardon me. That has gone over the fielder at deep square leg. That's super striking by Roshan Dhingra. There we see, yes, it's clearly over the A boards. That's a Rialta space is six. Sixer number 1075. Adnan Mukadam round the wicket. On the leg side again. This time around straight to the fielder. It's a catch taken. Spartan poker catch of the match. And an error committed by Roshan Dhingra. Not only in that shot, but also in not changing ends. He did not go for the run. As a result of which, Arvind is going to be off strike. He won't be able to take the strike. Because the umpire was nicely examining. He had his eyes. And they did not cross over. So it's going to be the new batsman, that is Aniket Pavaskar, to take strike. And he'll have to go all guns blazing from the first delivery all. Or all that he can do is just get a single and get Arvind Tandle back on strike. 119 for 5, 7.2 overs. Adnan Mukadam has considered 8 runs, 2 wides and a sixer. And then has picked up a wicket as well of Roshan Dhingra. Aniket Pavaskar meanwhile on strike. Will he go for the big hit? Yes, he does. Is it too good? No, it is in. So a super strike from Aniket Pavaskar. The first delivery faces a Rialta space of sixer. What a way to start the innings. High on confidence, perhaps. First delivery, big swing of the bat. It is inside the playing area. Rialta space of sixer goes again. And gets another Rialta space of sixer. So back-to-back sixers for Aniket Pavaskar. The skipper must be thinking, why didn't we send him up above the order today? Because it just looks like it is his day. Two deliveries he's faced, and both of them were action replays at the same area over the deep mid-wicket fielder. Rialta spaces 6, 131 on the board now for the loss of 5 wickets. What we thought, that Aniket should take a single and give strike to Arvind Tandle. Aniket has proven us wrong by scoring two deliveries and both of them sixers. Outside the off stump, well left by Aniket Pavaskar there. Just look at that. And that's a wide ball. So pressure perhaps on Adnan Mukadam. Sweeps well. Yet another Rialta spaces sixer. So Aniket Pavaskar is turning it on. 137 on the board. So what was looking difficult for the Sports 360 to reach 125? They are at 137 with a delivery to go. Aniket Pavaskar in full swing. There he goes, field under it. It might be a wicket and it's a catch taken. That's a Spartan poker catch of the match. Was it? It was a no ball in the previous delivery. I missed out on apologies. So that was an extra run. This was a free hit. So that was a single that was taken. Arvind Tandle comes down the track, sweeps straight to the field at deep square leg. Rohan Naik it is. That'll just be a single to end the innings for Sports 360 at 141 for the loss of 5 wickets at the end of their allotted 8 overs. A super innings at the end by Adnan. It was by Aniket Pavaskar of 19, 3 back-to-back sixers, and then he got a single. Whereas Arvind Tandle, the game-changer, super innings of 48 runs that he had. So, it's 141 for the loss of 5 wickets at the end of 8 overs. Our Sports 360 degrees. It's been a wonderful innings. Always good to see a super comeback from a batting side, and always good to see a good target. Sports 360 desperately need a win, and the target they have set is 142. That's we'll quickly have the toss of the next match. We'll head over to Preeti in just a few moments. In the meanwhile, it was 141. There's the batting scorecard. 49 for Arvind Tandle. Roshan scores 16, Aniket scores 19, 22 extras. Yes, so it was super innings by Arvind Tandle. 2 wickets for Seth, a wicket apiece for Sumit, Sufyan and Adnan. 8 overs, 142. That'll be the target for the Bewara Spartans. And they'll have to score at 17.62 runs per over. We'll head over to Preeti for the toss of match number 5.
And it's time for the last match of this day to be played by all monsters owned by Mr. Junaid Sharif, Vicky Kandhari and Navid Sharif versus Srishti Lions owned by Mr. Rohit Mishra and Raj Mishra. Well, to do the toss, we have Jameel Pathan, player family of All Monsters. And let's get ready to welcome both our teams from All Monsters. We have Junaid Sharif along with the youngest owner, Zahan Sharif, the son of Navid Sharif. And from Srishti Lions, we have Raj Mishra coming in. So let's have both our teams join in. Come on, guys, let's get ready for the toss and player family from All Monster. So, आपको कैसा लग रहा है यहाँ आकर?
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है मैम.
And आपके बेटे खेल रहे हैं यहाँ पर?
Yeah, they both are twins and they are playing in opposite team. Yeah.
Wow, twins playing in opposite team.
Yeah, they both are playing in opposite team. Each other, Mudassar Pathan and Mohsin Pathan.
Okay, so which team are both of them playing in?
And one thing, man, one is Monster and second
Lions.
Lions.
So, I mean, that would be really interesting. So, let's go ahead and see who wins this toss. Let's have the coin with Rialta on one side, DPL on other. Who calls for it? DPL on the other. Okay, who calls for it? Okay, so they're going to call and let's spin the coin. And you've called for DPL. That's Rialta's paces. Never mind. So, you won the toss. Congratulations. What would you choose to do?
We'll choose to field first.
All right, they've chosen to field and it is batting for you. Are you happy with the decision?
Not really. The first time you're going to bat first. Let's see.
It's the first time you've lost the toss?
Actually, the first time you've lost the toss.
Okay. So what number do you have in mind?
Nothing. 120 should be enough for them.
What is it?
120 should be enough for them.
120, quite a realistic figure they have in mind. And let's get ready to play and exchange a playing 11 and over to the turf.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to The Chase. This is the match that is in progress. Sports 360 degree versus the Bewara Spartans. The Sports 360 degree has scored 141 for the loss of 5 wickets. The target is 142 to win. In 8 overs, always a stiff target with a required run rate of more than 15 runs. The first ball played towards mid-on, could be close, but one run added there. One for no loss off the mark are Bewara Spartans. Bewara Spartans need 142 to win. One for no loss as we welcome in the commentator's box the ever-pleasing Mikhail Vaswani. Good evening, Mikhail.
Good evening, Prasanna, and I'm being welcomed with a crisp drive through covers as well. What a lovely way to come and sit in the comm box and see that shot being played. Well, thank you for that introduction, Prasanna. Uphill task here for Bewora Spartans. Sports 360 comes in with a huge entourage each time they come to play a match. A lot of support for them. Again, that big, big hit towards mid-wicket. Roshan is keeping things tight. Good start so far. Three deliveries as well with less runs conceded is always a good start.
Yeah, always a good start. Three for no loss. Faisal and Doke, the two batsmen at the crease. Three for no loss, the scoreboard reads. Roshan bowling the first over. It's going to be Doke on strike. Abhijit Doke and Faisal Khan. Roshan bowling the first over. Three for, oh, that's a fast ball given by the umpire who's behind the wicketkeeper. But the batsman says, I'm okay with the speed. So that's where the white signal. So now the batsmen have indicated that they are okay with the speed. Four for no loss, the scoreboard reads, is the first over in progress. Has swept across towards fine leg, one run added. Scoreboard moves on to five. Five for no loss. Never an easy target, Mikhail, to chase whenever the target is more than 140, which is above par that we've seen here.
Oh, yes, and look at that. Nicely hit towards mid-wicket for a single. But just look at the batting stance of most of the batsmen when they're chasing. They get into experimentation mode right from the beginning when you're chasing something like 140, 150. So they make their intention clear. And it makes it all the more difficult for a bowler to also pitch it and bowl it in the right areas. Because in this format, there's no right area, Prasanna. Yeah, right area becomes a wrong area in a fraction of a second.
Oh, absolutely. What a lovely point there you make, Mikhail. In this area, in this part of the game, or this format of the game, there's no right area. The first over comes to an end. A tidy over there. Seven for no loss. The scoreboard reads Faisal and Doke, the two batsmen at the crease. No loss is good for the Bewora Spartans, but they need to get around 15 to 20 runs every over if they have to get closer to that target of 142. Faisal Khan and Abhijit Doke, the two batsmen who are at the crease for the Bewora Spartans. Bewora Spartans at one point of time look like they'll restrict the opposition team to say about 100, 125, but at the end it was something that they could not close, and the Sports 360 degree batsmen, they took complete advantage of it, and that's where the scoreboard that read 141. That's in the air but over mid wicket for a Rialta Spaces maximum of the bat of Abhijit Doke. Good batting that, Mikhail, from Abhijit.
Oh yes, Hanoi, welcome there with a 6 over mid wicket. So pretty much certain what's the mindset of the batsmen right now. Abhijit Doke and Faisal Khan eyeing the big boundaries. Look at that stance. Almost ready to rock and roll there.
Yes, absolutely. Ready to rock and roll. That's a dot ball. 13 for no loss, the scoreboard reads. The second over that is in progress. Which way is the match going? The target is 141. In the air, but away from the fielder towards deep mid-wicket, two runs added. Scoreboard moves on to 15. So nice little partnership that is going on for the Bewora Spartans, but they need to get this going.
Oh yes, good thing for them is they still have 10 wickets in hand. 15 for no loss, early days in this chase of theirs. Sports 360, the dugout is buzzing, and they have a lot of fans supporting them. Hanoi Kumar conceding a 6 in the first ball has come back well. Doke again shuffling here, there, jump here, a twist there. Prasanna, Doke is quite an entertainer there. Here we go.
Yes, quite an entertainer. Comes down the wicket, oh, hits that hard, ricochets off the stumps. It'll be just a single. Scoreboard moves on to 16. So those big hits that they're looking at to come at a regular stage, that is something that is eluding them. Hanoi Kumar, who's bowling the second over, 16 for no loss. Not yet got to that flying start that the Bewora Spartans would have loved to get on to.
Oh yes, they'll need one good over just to put things on track for themselves. Making room for himself. Nicely bowled, tossed up delivery. Spinning away from the batsman. He should have come closer there, Faisal. In fact, went away and made it difficult for himself to reach, get to the reach of the ball.
Yes, that's where that shot was attempted, but couldn't quite get that connection. 16 for no loss, the scoreboard reads. We're bringing these pictures live to you from the Astro Park at the St. Stanislaus Sports Complex in Bandra West, Mumbai. all these matches live on D-Sport. The last ball coming up, the second over. Oh, that's given as a no ball. Given as a no ball for the sidearm. And that's a no ball. Yes, immediately the umpire behind the wicketkeeper called for it. And he stood with his decision. He said, yes, that's the way that I have called a free hit coming up.
Oh, yes, and a very firm decision by the umpire. Contested by the wicketkeeper and bowler. But he was very sure, and now this is a free hit, which means it's an opportunity once again for Bewara Spartans to get a big hit. We are at the St. Stanislaus Astra Park in Bandra, Mumbai. Has he got the free big hit? Not really. Oh my God! What's just happened? Is that a six? Oh my God, the rush of blood. The rush of blood may have just prompted him to do something very silly. And this is amusement all the way. That is amusement all the way. Let me tell you, we need to see that in replays.
Oh yes, we need to see that in replay. It was a free hit. It is a free hit, all our viewers. It has just woken up everyone. See, it was a free hit. He took the catch. See what he does. He celebrates that and he throws the ball out of the boundary line. That's a six of a free hit. Oh my goodness, we haven't seen this. Mikhail, you've been broadcasting for all these years. Have you seen that happen?
That has brought the entire Stanislaus Park into laughter as everyone has burst into raptures over here. And he's the man. He's also sharing a smile with everybody. We can have a hearty laugh over there. But what just happened is actually a brain freeze moment. One of the most bizarre moments that we've seen in DPL history. And let me tell you, Steve Smith can have a brain freeze moment, so can that gentleman as well.
Oh yes, 23 for no loss, the scoreboard reads. And even the DJ was brought to life. He also started playing music after seeing that. Everybody here around us have left their seats and come to see that action replay.
And Prasanna, guess what? He's still laughing. He's Roshan there. He's still smiling. And he knows what he's done. He's brought everybody on the feet over here. And okay, Roshan, let's forget about it. It's over. We're not going to get back to it. Let's get back to the game.
Oh, yes, absolutely. That's done and dusted now. But that has to be one of the most entertaining pieces of action that we've seen at this Rialta Spaces Dreams Premier League. Okay, coming back to normalcy. 23 for no loss. The third over that starts with a wide.
And Prasan, I have to add this. They are called Sports 360 and he practically did a 360 over there.
Oh, yes, absolutely. 360 degree that was. That's in the air. And this time, the fielder takes the catch, doesn't celebrate. First wicket falls down. Bewara Spartans are 24 for 1.
And that's why it's the safer option is to catch the ball and keep it in your pocket, Prasanna. Most captains and players would do that after taking a catch. Good break here, Siddesh Kadam there with that catch. Very nicely done. Very nicely taken. Looking for that big hit, taking it on the full. Just nicely taken, Siddesh. Getting behind the ball. That's experience.
Yes, that's experience, that is calmness, that is composure, all summed up into one. 24 for one, the scoreboard reads. The new batsman there for the Sports 360 for the Bewara Spartans is Rohan Naik. Rohan Naik and Faisal Khan, the two batsmen who are at the crease. Rohan Naik is the new man in. A gentle full toss, plays that towards mid-off for a single. He gets off the mark. It's important for the Bewara Spartans to not get too back in terms of the required run rate, because it's always going to be an uphill task, as Mikhail rightly mentioned, because 140, any target which is above 135, 140, never easy to chase in 8 overs. They've lost one wicket. Kunal Sonawale, who is bowling over number 3, 25 for 1. Always the Sports 360 degree have a good support. It's in the air. Aman, the fielder, takes that catch. Another wicket that goes down, 25 for 2.
Interestingly, the moment Aman took the catch, the fielder next to him told, don't throw it so hard, take it easy. Catch well taken, another breakthrough, another wicket falls for Bewara Spartans. Sports 360 here are taking complete grasp of the match. Take a look at the fielder close to him. He's saying, Aman, telling Aman, take it easy, Aman, take it easy. Don't throw it back into the sixth boundary over there. But that's how it is. They're excited. They're ecstatic. There's euphoria. And they're celebrating.
Oh, yes, absolutely. They're celebrating. And why not 25 for 2 as Saif Ali is the new batsman who's walking out of the crease. Saif Ali and Rohan Naik, the two new batsmen, they have a job in hand to be done. That's a single taken towards mid-off. One run added, scoreboard moves on to 26. They need those big hits, Mikhail. But what an over this has been from Karan Sonawale. Just 3 runs and 2 wickets. Top class bowling. The fielder there at long on, as you can see on your screens. If the ball goes to him, there's going to be all action-packed entertainment once again. That's an outside edge, takes a single. 27, the scoreboard moves on.
I'm waiting for the ball to go towards long on and see what's the reaction of not just Rohan, but the rest of the fielders as well. Their hearts will skip a beat. But yes, what a lovely over by Karan Sonawale. Just 4 runs, 2 wickets. This is top performance here by Sports 360. Just taking complete control of the proceeding. Nicely hit. Oh, what an effort. What an effort there. That ball was traveling. It was flat. It had speed on it. But Aman, once again, throwing himself. It was to the left of Aman. He almost got there. Almost got there. But another daring shot. This is the big moment coming in for them right now.
Yes, big moment. 33. So that's where they are on course going into that net on valve. Double, treble over. Around 35-40 is always a good score to go into the net on valve. Double, treble over. But now this is a crucial over. If they can get about 20 runs, which will count as 40, because all runs in the net on valve double treble over are doubled. A wicket that goes down, 10 runs are deducted. So if they can get about 20 runs and they'll count as 40, they'll get that score to about 75-80. That's what we always talk about. But the net on valve double treble over is always been one of that overs, one of those overs where the players haven't been able to decide as to should we attack or should we take it defensively. But let's see which way the game goes. Arun Yadav, it looks like, for the Sports 360 degree, who has the ball in hand. He'll be getting ready to bowl. The batsman getting the handkerchief all over their grips because they know they don't want the bat to slip now. The ball has already slipped once for the fielding team.
No more slip-ups, Prasanna. No more slip-ups. But it's been pretty much a pattern, right? When a team is chasing a big total, we regard that number four over as the make-or-break over, the deciding factor. That big moment where, you know, things can just go either ways, that make or break over. Once again, Devora Spartans, if they can really think of coming back into the game, this is their chance. And if they have to lose the plot, again, this is the chance.
Yes, absolutely. Either this way or that way. But which way will the game go? As Saif Ali gets ready to take strike with handkerchief wrapped all around the grip. Arun Yadav with the ball in hand, bowling round the wicket. There's a silly point in place. Played towards covers, just a single. So that's okay for both the teams. One will count as two. 35, the scoreboard moves on.
If we could get that silly point little behind to short point, or rather short covers, he'll stop that single and that'll save 2 runs. I guess it's very important for captains to bring in a little bit more imagination and sensibilities as well, because at the end of the day, you want to stop the single because the batsman will think twice before playing a big shot, Prasanna.
Oh, yes, absolutely. The batsman will always think twice about playing that big shot. And as you rightly said, that silly point, maybe a few yards, 3 or 4 yards behind, and he'll save that single because I don't think he's going to take a catch there. Yes, it'll happen once in a blue moon where it happened in the earlier stage where the batsman went for that sweep and the fielder at forward short leg caught that catch. Well, he was actually trying to just take evasive action, but the ball just stuck into his left armpit. That happens once in a moment. But very rare that you will see a catch being taken at a silly point, a bat and pad, a bat and leg, as we were to say. Very rare to see that. So if he's just a couple of yards behind, as you rightly said, he can save a few singles for sure.
And Prasanna, coming back to the non-striker, I'm eager to see if batsmen back up at this point in time after what Ravichandran Ashwin did the other day. Munkering, may I add, is a rule. It's part of the law that has been put across. Nicely hit. That'll be a maximum. 6 becomes 12. Much needed Rialta spaces maximum. And this will be a welcome sign for Bevora Spartans, who've just got into their rut right now and not able to come out of it. Breaking the shackles there. Very good shot.
Oh yes, absolutely. Breaking the shackles. A good shot there. Inside out. Taking it on the full over covers for a Rialta spaces maximum. And because we are in the net on valve double treble over, that's 6. Will count as 12.
Yeah, Prasanna, coming back to the non-striker as well, I'm sure no batsman will want to back up now. Just take a look at the non-striker. Right inside his crease. The cricket world has been divided between the laws of the game and the spirit of the game. And this has been a subjective matter, opening a debate worldwide in the cricketing world. And it's important that batsmen also realize that they need to remain inside that crease, because this is a legal dismissal that we are talking about.
Yes, and look at what an effect that it has had on gully cricket as well. So even in gully cricket, underarm cricket, turf cricket, the non-striker just not leaving the crease, in the air, over the fielder there, at short extra covers for another Rialta Spaces boundary. The scoreboard moves on to 53 and now 57, because that boundary will count as 8, because we are in the Niton valve, double trouble over.
Just over the fielder at covers there. 4 becomes 8. Productive over this for Bevora Spartans. They're taking their chances. This is the moment that they can actually capitalize and bring themselves back in the chase. Not that they're off the boil at the moment. Just that could add a lot of solidity. I can see a familiar face there. Chaitanya. What is he doing in the dugout of the Sports 360? Ah, that could be close for balls in no man's land.
Yes, just imagine if that would have been taken, 10 runs deducted. Oh, what an over that would have been for the Sports 360. But not to be, 4 overs bowled. The Bevora Spartans are 59 for the loss of 2 wickets. They're chasing a target of 141 with 4 overs still to go. It's always going to be a tough chase. It's always going to be a tough chase for the Bevora Spartans. And looking back, they'll think that they conceded a few extra runs with their bowling. The bowlers didn't quite finish it off well, as they should have, as it is Aniket Pavaskar with the ball in hand. He batted really well when it was the business end of the innings, but now it looks like he's going to bowl over number 5. 59 for 2. It's going to be a tough chase, Mikhail, because it's never easy to chase a target which is more than 135, but with 2 set batsmen, relatively set batsmen, Rohan Naik batting well on 15, Saif Ali batting on 7. We've seen funny things happen on the cricket turf here.
Oh yes, and I like this boy, Siddesh Kadam. I feel he brings in a lot of assurance to the Sports 360 side. Very fast fielder, very solid, compact batsman, and a very dependable bowler. You need players like him, where the captain can say, okay Siddesh, you're my go-to man, you're my man Friday. Ah, nicely bowled once again. Very nicely bowled. You know, you need gutsy cricketers, Prasanna. You know, feisty customers. You can see by the body language as well. He's ready for the challenge. He's enjoying himself. Nicely bowled. Nicely hit as well.
Yes, nicely bowled, but nicely hit inside out there once again. That shot was so nicely timed. He made some room for himself and hit that over extra covers for a Rialta Spaces maximum. Good batting this. Scoreboard moves on to 65. This is the 5th over in progress. Saif Ali batting on 13. Rohan Naik batting on 15. Both the batsmen now looking to take the game towards their team score. Which way is the game going? 22 balls to go. 77 runs to win, played towards long gone for a single. What a wonderful angle that is to see that game from the top angle. The turf that you can see, it's absolutely top class that we see. But brilliant cricket that we have seen. Goes for the sweep, premeditated, takes it on the full, could be close at the non-striker's end, but one run added. Scoreboard moves on to 67 for the loss of 2 wickets. This is the 5th over in progress, 2 balls to go. The target is always going to be tough, the target of 142. But 67, the scoreboard reads. Nicely bowled once again by Siddesh Kadam. He's doing the job for the team. As always, the most dependable of the players. You look for such players in your side. Given as a fast ball by the umpire there. As you can see, that raised hand is not a bye. Once the umpire behind the wicketkeeper raises that hand, it's an indication that it is a fast delivery. It's beyond the acceptable pace that the batsman wants it to be. And that's where it's a fast ball that is given. 67 for 2, the scoreboard remains. It is given as a dead ball. 1 ball to go of the 5th over. Saif Ali batting on 14. Rohan Naik batting on 16. It's important that both these batsmen get the next two overs in their control, but not quite able to get the runs. A dot ball to finish five overs. Devora Spartans chasing a target of 142 are 67 for the loss of two wickets. So the sixth over coming up. The Bevora Spartans need 75 runs to win in 18 balls. Which way is the game going? As of now, it looks to be the Sports 360 degree team who are in control. But as always, whenever they want to make a bowling change, it is always that they'll have a team huddle, a team meeting of sorts, and then they'll arrive at a conclusion of which bowler will be bowling the next over. So that's where we are getting ready to bowl the sixth over. It's going to be Arvind Tandley, who scored that valiant unbeaten 49 with the bat, is getting ready with the ball in hand. Arvind Tandley, it is going to be to bowl the sixth over. 67 for two, the scoreboard reads. 18 balls to go, 75 to win. The Sports 360 degree team need to do really something about the pace that they bowl their overs at, the time that they follow, because they take a lot of time to take a decision who is going to bowl the next over. Rohan Naik to face. He'll be facing Arvind Tandley. There's a silly point that is in place. Vishnu is the fielder there at silly point. Takes it on the full, and that'll be a Rialta spaces maximum. Good batting this from Rohan Naik. He's premeditating all these shots. He knows that there is the leg side that he wants to attack, and he is attacking that at will. Took that on the full and hit that over square leg for a Rialta spaces maximum. This time he goes on the other side of the pitch, goes for the switch hit, just a single. Scoreboard moves on to 74. 74 for two. Four balls still to go. The sixth over in progress. Could start to this over for the Bevora Spartans. But the target now is looking really far away for them. They're not quite getting the consistency of the big hits. Once again, nicely bowled. Good bowling. Well kept there by Amol Matre, the wicketkeeper, nicely collecting that ball. Could have been close had he managed to be just a few inches in front from where he is now. But that's always the case, that the wicketkeepers always look at saving the runs more than the wickets. It's a full toss, and that will be a Rialta spaces maximum. Scoreboard moves on to 80. That's a good score in six overs, if we were to say. But if we look at the target that they are chasing, it's always very, very difficult to do that. The scoreboard that reads 80 for the loss of two wickets. This is the sixth over in progress. Two balls to go. Oh, that's way outside the off stump. That'll be a wide ball. 81, the scoreboard moves on to. So these wides are also adding on to the tally. That's in the air, and that will be a Rialta spaces maximum. Brilliant batting this from Saif Ali. Saif Ali and Rohan Naik, the two batsmen, are trying their best to get as close to the target that is possible. But that's where you can see the team owners there, the team management, thinking that, oh, it's just too many runs that their bowlers conceded. A Rialta spaces maximum to finish the sixth over. Six overs bowled, Bevora Spartans are 93 for the loss of two wickets. Two overs still to go and 49 runs to win. Two overs still to go, 12 balls, 49 required. Saif Ali and Rohan Naik, the two batsmen, are they threatening to take the game in the favor of Bevora Spartans? Can they do that? Will that be possible to do that? Or is it too far away? 49 to win in 12 balls. It's tough, but not impossible. Bowling change. It's going to be Aniket Pavaskar to bowl the seventh over. And Aniket will be bowling to Rohan Naik. Rohan Naik and Saif Ali, the two batsmen who are batting really well. They've struck together a good partnership, but just looks like it has come a little too late for the Bevora Spartans. Had they managed to get those big hits a couple of overs early, that target of 49 in 12 balls could have come a little lower. And that's Spartan poker catch of the match in contention. Arvind Tandley has had a wonderful night with the yellow jersey on. The third wicket that goes down, Bevora Spartans now are 93 for 3. It was a full toss. Rohan Naik went for his favourite shot over the covers, but didn't quite get the timing nor the elevation in that shot. Loses wicket. 93 now for the loss of 3 wickets are Bevora Spartans. Now the target will look even more difficult, because even when Rohan Naik and Saif Ali were there, it was looking difficult. But now that Rohan Naik is back, and now it's going to be Manan Mehta who is walking onto the crease, now it's going to look even more difficult. 11 balls, 49. Never easy for a new batsman to just come and go hammer and tongs. Very difficult for a new batsman to get the big hits in. Rohan Naik there out on 23 in 10 balls. Manan Mehta, the batsman to be on strike, getting that handkerchief all wrapped up on the grip. Seventh over coming up. The first ball, it was a wicket. 5 balls still to go. Can they get 3 sixes in this? That will bring the match all alive once again. 11 balls to go and 49 runs to win. In the air, straight to the fielder. 2 back-to-back wickets. That will again be in contention for the Spartan poker. Catch of the match. The fourth wicket that goes down. 93 for 4 are the Bevora Spartans. Completely losing their way are the Bevora Spartans. Now that they've lost 2 back-to-back wickets, not only have they added pressure on themselves in terms of the dot balls, but now that they're losing wickets, the captain there has to walk back, Manan Mehta. The new batsman that is coming in is Mohammad Momin, who will be there at the crease to take strike. 10 balls to go, 49 to win. So mathematical equation tells us that every ball has to go for a 6. And they should expect a few no balls also to come. Oh, that would have been as plump as possible if there was an LBW. This allowed appeal, but turned down for the run out at the striker's end. 1 run added. Scoreboard moves on to 94. If there was an LBW, that would have been a hat-trick for sure for Aniket Pavaskar. But not to be. Good fielding there by Vishnu Adhikari. Nicely done by Amol Mathre. But the batsman had made his crown good. 1 run added after all this action. 94 for 4, the scoreboard reads. This is the 7th over in progress. Mohammad Momin is at the non-striker's end. Saif Ali now batting on 32. Takes it on the full, but that's what the team has missed. The Bevora Spartans, they haven't been able to dispatch these loose deliveries over the boundary line. This was a gentle full toss, but couldn't quite put that over the boundary rope. That's again a dot ball. Once again, good bowling this from Aniket. Could be close, and he has given out. That's another wicket that goes down. And now Bevora Spartans have just given it up, it looks like, because the body language also not that positive from the team. Here also, there was never a run there at mid-on. It was straight into the hands of Arun Yadav. Good collection by Aniket himself, and the umpire there, Karunakar Kotian, once again in an excellent position to adjudicate that and take a decision. 95 for 5 as Sufyan Chauhan is the new batsman who will be taking strike to face the last ball of the 7th over. Comes down the wicket. Oh, the fielder did a valiant attempt there at long off to take that catch. Aman, the fielder, but not quite able to get that catch. A Rialta spaces boundary to finish 7 overs. 99, the scoreboard reads, for the loss of 5 wickets. 1 over to go, 43 runs to win. The team in yellow, Sports 360 Degree will be happy. They'll be delighted because their team has done really well. At one point of time, when Chaitanya was doing this commentary stint, it looked like the team may not reach 120, 125. But not only did they reach 120, they crossed 140. They were in contention to reach at about 150. But 142 is the target. And six balls to go. 43 runs to win. It's going to be the Sports 360 Degree team who looks like will get another win under their belt. That'll make them feel good and also help them to raise their run rate, because they've scored a good score of 140, 142, which is more than 15 runs per over. And more than that, if they can restrict Bevora's partners to less than 110, 120, it'll help them to get their net run rate. Because at the end, where four each from both the groups are going to go to the quarterfinal stage, eight teams, remember, qualified to the quarterfinals, it's going to be net run rate if it gets really close. Nicely piercing that gap between covers and long off for a Rialta Spaces boundary. That brings up the century for the Bevora Spartans. Scoreboard moves on to 103 for the loss of 5 wickets. 5 balls still to go, 39 to wins. Just formalities left, because the Bevora Spartans, I'm sure the team management will look at. That's another Rialta Spaces maximum. Scoreboard moves on to 33, that is required in 4 balls. Scoreboard moves on to 109. The Bevora Spartans team management will look at saying that 142 was always going to be a tough target, but it could have been in reach had the top 3 or 4 managed to accelerate a little earlier than when they actually started to accelerate. Because that's where, if you see now, 3 balls to go, 32 to win. So if they fall short by about 20-25 runs, they'll think that had they managed to get those runs earlier, that could have been a different story altogether. An appeal there for a run out, and the umpire has signaled to the TV umpire. The catch that went down, so that catch dropped by Arun Yadav, but he compensated it well by recovering well and throwing that ball. Let's see if that's a run out. It's close, and it looks to be out. Yes. That is out. The ball has hit the stumps. The bat is inches short of the crease. And that is where it is another wicket that goes down. 110 for the loss of 6 wickets, that the scoreboard reads now. Sufyan Chauhan, the batsman on strike, comes down the wicket, not quite able to get the elevation behind that shot. So still 32 required, and that's where the Bevora Spartans, two things that they'll have to think. That's a full toss, and that'll be taken by Arvind Tandley. Another wicket that goes down. 110 now for the loss of 7 wickets. Completely losing their way are the Bevora Spartans, because not only have they been able to chase, but more than that, the way that they played the game, they'll think that they conceded a few extra runs at the back end of the overs, and they did not accelerate at the right moment when they actually should have gone for the shots. They did not go, and that's where they left too much to be done for the tail end, and that's where they found the game all lost in disdain. So that's how the game stands. Chasing a target of 142, the Bevora Spartans scored 110 for the loss of 7 wickets. Is what the scoreboard reads, and 32.